My Greek mythology tour of Brighton was inspired by a painting inside the Brighton Museum and Art Gallery by Harry Morley. It's a painting of the Judgment of Paris, so the start of the Trojan Wars, where Paris had to decide who was the fairest out of Aphrodite, Hera and Athena. Greek mythology is all around us. It's in it's on television programmes, it's in advertisements, it's in art. And so the idea behind this was to make it local. It's quite nice to be able to share a different story and something direct from the ancient authors, but in an easy way to understand.
There are lots of different objects that link directly to Greek mythology, but even more interesting, out and about in the streets and even in shops and in advertising, then there are things that could have links with the gods and goddesses, and I really wanted to share my knowledge with people so they'll think again when they're walking around Brighton.
Surely this place hasn't got anything to do with Greek mythology.
Well, you might think not. Vegetarian shoes and Greek mythology, but this lovely picture of a cow up here with her boots ready for walking has a lot of links in my mind to the story of Io. So Io was the daughter of a king and a nymph, and she was very beautiful, and the king of the gods Zeus fell in love with her, and his wife Hera was very jealous. And so according to one version of the story, Hera turned her into a cow. In another version of the story, Zeus turned her into a cow to stop Hera from killing her, but whatever happened, she ended up being a cow, and Hera sent a gadfly after her to torment her, and it would bite her, and she walked all around the world. And so these boots are really appropriate. The lovely mask behind me reminds me very much of the mask of Agamemnon, which is a golden mask that was found by the early archaeologist Heinrich Schliemann in the 19th century. Schliemann was looking for evidence of the Trojan Wars.
And have your talks had a good response from people?
Yes, I've had an excellent response. I've done a number of talks in London and one in Uckfield, and also some in local schools in Brighton and Eastbourne. And all the people come to me afterwards and are interested to learn more and want to read more, and I've been asked to go back and talk again. And so I think these stories really resonate with us today.
You mentioned doing the actual tour for real.
Yes, I'd love to do this. If people would like to come along. When I did the first tour myself, there was quite a lot of walking, but actually you could use more buses, and so to go to the different stops and the museums, and probably could spend about 2 to 3 hours around Brighton sharing the stories in the actual place. So this could be something that could be done in the Brighton Fringe Festival potentially, so I'd really love to do that if people were interested in actually doing the tour live, if you like.
This is Charlene French for the latest TV news.